precision tolerances for 3D printed threads and bolts. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about answering a question that I get asked quite a bit in my Blender Precision series in the offset video, which is how would I go about offsetting a nut and bolt for 3D printing so that it works perfectly. I've been asked a couple of times about this question of how to do screw holes for bolts. So this includes how to do a threaded insert. On top of that, here, Still Point X, which was the first person to ask, also asked how would he go about creating an already existing hole if you had a thread into a bolt or something to screw into here. So let me go ahead and show you both how to create the bolts that fit in with 3D print tolerances and also how to go about creating a bolt from just the threads that you're given. First and foremost, the simplest way of creating a bolt is by using an add-on that is shipped with Blender. So if you go into Preferences, Add-ons, type in bolt, you will have a bolt factory. So then with that, you just go Shift A, inside of Mesh, you have bolt, and this lets you create nuts and bolts. And there's a lovely preset here, so you can pick which bolt it is. So if you have a 3D object that already has a thread in it, and you know what that thread correlates with, it's as easy as that. You've got it here. Now, let's go ahead and put a nut on here. So how would you go about adding the simplest way a tolerance for a 3D print from this? Well, you would change it here. Keep in mind that the major is the outer part of a bolt, so it's the outer part here of a nut, and the minor is the inner part here of a nut. I know that for my 3D printer, I am 10.2 millimeter offset, and on diameter, I'm going to actually use the mathematical. So I'm going to go plus 0.2, and that there is a nut that would be 3D printable to work with M10 bolts on my 3D printer. Alternatively, if you already have your bolts that you're wanting to make, and let's say this was some other very large object that needed a certain thread placed in it, well, we'd know something that would cut away a thread. So I'm just going to do a duplication here, place it back on here. I'm going to move this on the Z now by 40 downwards, so that puts it perfectly in place face to face to my object. Now, what I want to do here is just cut away, do a bool. So I'm going to select my nut and let's go ahead and go control minus, and there we have a bool operation. Now we have some intersecting faces here, so let's just go ahead and move this bolt up on the Z by 0.001, and that will sort that out fantastically. All right, so there we have it. That's our thread placed in, but now how would we go about doing our offset? Well, the great thing is two things. We have now, because this is a bool operation, we have our operator, our cutaway, can be moved wherever we want this hole to be. Now, on top of that, because it is a cut operator, and the cut operator is a 3D object, we can now use our lovely modifier of the Solidify like we used in the offset video. So let's go ahead, add the Solidify. And now this time you'll see we've got the Solidify. We've got to make sure that it is only the rim. Instead of minus one, we're going to go plus one to expand our 3D cutting object. We're going to make sure that we have even thickness and high quality normals. The thickness that I'm going for here is 0.2, and that there is what I'm wanting to get. Now, of course, my cutting object has the head of this bolt. So we've got to quickly go into edit mode with this bolt. We're going to select just the top half. So let's go ahead. I'm going to hit forward slash to isolate just this one here. I'm now going to go into vertex select, select that top vertex here. If it will let me, come on. There we go. And now I'm just going to do my control plus on the numpad to increase my selection till I'm all the way down to the base of where the thread starts. Then I'm just going to quickly go G, Z, move this up so it no longer intersects with the face. Then I'm going to do my forward slash once again to show everything. Go out of edit mode, make sure that I'm outside of my wireframe x-ray view, and there we go. That's our now our thread placed with an offset. Now, this is by far is my favorite way of doing it, because if all of a sudden I'm using a different material and the thickness or the offset of my thread needs to be changed, I can change it right here by just changing the amount right here, which is fantastic for me. This works the best. So 0.2, so that there is how to create a thread itself. Now let's get on to StillPointX's question. So here we have pretty much the exact scenario that StillPointX had for us. So here we have a thread that's placed in a cube that we can see right there, and we're wanting to get a bolt out of this thread. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go into our edit mode, and let's say that this was a much more complicated object, so it's a pain to delete everything. So let's go ahead and do our face selection. Let's select these bottom faces down here. And now let's just go Control Pad Plus and select all the way up this thread. Fantastic. Now let's go ahead and go Control Pad Minus. So now we have just the thread, and double checking that we have everything selected. So it looks like we have to select a couple more things here. So I'm going to use my C for circle select and select what's left to be selected here. And just in case, I want to overselect, unselect that, and reselect all that edge to double check that I have everything. It looks like right here as well. And that looks like everything is selected. So now that we have that selected, now what I'm going to go is just go Shift D to duplicate it out, go Z to move it out, and now we have a complete and exact copy of our thread. So let's go ahead and hit P to part this out by selection. So now we have this object here of the thread itself. Now let's just hit point to focus this into view. Let's go back into our edit mode and just very quickly let's create some sort of handle for this. So let's go ahead and let's do our 2 for edge select, and let's make sure we select our edge right here. So let's go, yeah, making sure we got the right edge. Go alt click to select that path. Fantastic. And just to make life a little bit easier, what I'm going to do is go F to fill it, and we're going to work from here on out. So let's go ahead, let's select this face, let's extrude it out. So right this minute, we're creating the shaft of the bolt itself. So let's give it, let's be precise about this. Let's say we were wanting this shaft to be 0.25 sounds like a reasonable amount. Let's go the other direction, 0.25, fantastic. Now I'm gonna E to extrude this out. I want the head of this to be, let's say, 5 millimeters, fantastic. Now I'm going to do my circle selection around here. I'm going to go with Alt E, and we're going to extrude, here we go, extrude along normals, and we're going to extrude this lovely weird bolt nut out. Now of course we could change this to some other completely different shape, and just for the sake of it, let's just say that that's it, because I want to make my life pretty easy. But of course, you could just go ahead and remodel this to any shape you're wanting this nut to be. Or you could even go ahead and create a different object. So using modeling and then using the bool tool to connect those two objects together. Okay, so now we have our bolt here and our thread down there. Now, we already know how to go about and change this here using our modifier of Solidify. However, that would affect sort of like the entire object. Now, we also know about vertex groups, so you could do this via vertex group. So let's do this, but instead of doing it to the inner thread here, let's say for some reason we want this thread to be unchanged. We're only wanting this to be changed. Okay, so let's work with just this. So let's first go ahead and create a vertex group. So clicking into the object, and let's make sure that we select what we're wanting to select. So plus, numpad plus, go all the way up this thread. Let's do this a different way. Let's select it all here. So all selected. Now let's use our circle select to deselect the top bit. Make sure that if we go into X-ray as well, this way around, circle select, and this way we can deselect all of this all in one go. Fantastic. That works for me. And there we have it. Let me deselect this last circular bit as well. So let's view from down below. Let's hit 5 to change from perspective to orthographic. And now let's use our circle select and middle click to deselect all of this. So now we're left with just the threading, so to speak. Hitting 5 on the numpad once again. So remember, if you have a laptop, you're going to have to use the emulator for that. And now let's create the vertex group. So into our vertex groups, vertex group plus, let's call this bolt thread. So with that bolt thread now created, let's assign the selection to that. And it's as easy as that. So now that we have that done, let's go back into our object mode, select our thread here. And let's go into our modifier, add a modifier, add our solidify. And look, lo and behold, our solidifier has our vertex group option right here. So let's click that, hit bolt thread. So now it's only going to change the thickness of our bolt thread. Now, of course, my 3D printer prints things out too big, so I need to go the other way around here. So let's go ahead with that selected. We're going to go minus offset. We're going to go even thickness, original, only rim. Make sure that this is making things smaller, which it is. Fantastic. Let's just go ahead and flip our normals so things are working the way they should be working. Let me just double check that I'm doing this right, which apparently I'm not, because here I'm making things bigger. Let me go the other way, so we're not flipping normals. Let me just double check that. Yeah, that's how I'm wanting it. So what we're going to go is minus 0.2, and that has now created the thread that I can 3D print with the offset of my 3D printer to fit into a thread that I did not have the bolt for before. So I hope that helps you guys out. And this pretty much works for anything. Be it for threads, be it for other objects, be it for a weird shaped thing that you're trying to put in. Using the Solidify tool to create these offsets gives you a parametric way of doing this. Now, if you don't want to deal with all this and being exactly precisely accurate, there is a little bit of a rougher cheats way, so to speak, but there's nowhere near as much precision. So to do that, let's say we're wanting to change this thread to be just that teeny little bit bigger. Well, to do that offset, we'll go ahead, click into this, go into our edit mode once again. Let's select our thread once again here. So let's go ahead and do that. And let's select it all up. Fantastic. Now I'm going to just deselect what we're not needing here. Why is it not doing it now? Whoops. Oh, let's just make this easier. Circle select, select that all here. Deselect the top. There we go. Make sure that we've caught everything. And because I wasn't an X-ray, I didn't catch everything. So select it all up. Deselect these outer ones now. And now what you can do is the quickest way, but really you lose a lot of accuracy here, is by just making sure that we're on individual origins or medium point. Probably medium point's going to be the way we're wanting to go here. Hitting S for the scale, and this lets you scale. Now, of course, this gives us a problem. Let me just go undo. If we were to scale this up from this angle, you'll see that it's scaling it upwards as well. It looks like I have something selected underneath. Let me just double check that. What's being selected? Oh, this face. So how would I go about constraining that? Now, I have shown you this before, but just as a reminder, so let's go ahead, hit S for scaling. So we're scaling this here. Now, we are not wanting this to scale in the Z axis. So let's go ahead and hit Shift Z, and that isolates Z out of the equation. So now we only are scaling in the X and the Y. So now we can go ahead and put in an scale offset amount. Let's go for 1 point, I don't know, completely ballpark. Let's go 1.2. This is going to obviously be far too big, but that there would then offset your scaling, so to speak, offset this thread outwards. But as I've said before, my preferred method is to use the Solidify, because that really gives you millimeter accuracy to the highest degree you can possibly control. And that's how to go about doing tolerances for nuts and bolts and 3D printing in Blender. And really, it turns perfectly. And as you can see, it's just using Solidify a little bit differently. Now, if you've made it this far, I think you're worth a little extra tip, which is if you are going to go about doing 3D printed bolts, maybe consider doing them this way instead, so you can print them flat. Now, the reason why you do this is that means that the layer lines are going this way on the bolt, which makes them a lot stronger to pull forces, and they work just the same with the nut. There you have it. Works just the same with the pull wise. Anyway, I hope you'd enjoy this. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome. And if you think I'm worthy of your support, I'd love to see you there too. Thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.